I got into this business in part because my dad told me when I was growing up, you know, you're no genius. He'd say it out of the blue, and he meant it, not meanly, I think, but just matter-of-factly. And I grew up with this father who not only was obsessed with how much of a genius his kids were or weren't, but also was obsessed with achievement, and I think I did inherit that from him. When I was a classroom teacher, I realized that there was a yawning gap between what kids could do and what they did do. And again, the reverse engineering of greatness is so that all of the kids that we know and love can become a little more great. Catherine Cox, Stanford University. She systematically pored over thousands of pages of diaries, primary biographical data from 301 geniuses, asking the question that my father asked, what makes a genius? The tendency not to abandon tasks from mere changeability, not seeking something fresh because of novelty, not always looking for a change. That's what I mean by passion for what you do. Second, the tendency not to abandon tasks in the face of obstacles, perseverance, tenacity, doggedness. And this brings me to the modern day study of grit. Grit is sustained passion and perseverance for especially long-term goals. I believe that there is such a thing as talent. Without actually doing something, you'll never develop skill. Skill is what happens when talent is multiplied by effort. You may have heard of the 10,000-hour rule. You will meet countless individuals who have done something for 10,000 hours and are still mediocre. What makes the difference is not the quantity of practice so much as the quality of those 10,000 hours. I think most people start off like potential world-class performers. They know nothing, they learn, but at some point they walk into work and they do the same thing on Wednesday that they did on Tuesday. And that is what keeps you on what I call the plateau of arrested development. Here's a third option. You can even miss the plateau of arrested development. You can drop out of what you do. What happens when human beings drop out of things, maybe you spoke a foreign language, maybe you played a musical instrument like I did, is that you lose that skill. Human skill is really use it or lose it. And what worries me is that some kids and some grown-ups keep dropping out of things, and they're never on any red learning curve to excellence. Now, I said quality mattered, but what exactly do I mean? There are really only four elements of the kind of practice that world-class achievers do. First, world-class experts have a very conscious intention in mind when they sit down to do something. It's extraordinarily precise. But if you went to work last week and you didn't know exactly what you were trying to get better at, my contention is that you were not doing deliberate practice. Second, 100% focus. Full heart, full effort. The lesson is concentration, effort, focus. Third, feedback, data. You need to know, did I make the shot or did I not make the shot? How did that sound when I pulled the bow like this? What was my time on that lap? What happens is that feedback is typically negative. Here's what you didn't do that you wanted to do, and are you willing to do the fourth thing? The fourth thing that world-class experts do that is different from most of us is that they truly listen to the feedback. They reflect, they make an adjustment, and they start the cycle all over again. So before we wrap up, let me finish this story about me and my dad. Little girl, South Jersey, told she's no genius, thinks about it for a moment, has to agree, grows up, and in 2013 is told by the MacArthur Foundation that actually she is a genius. And here's what I really want to say. If genius means getting things in life effortlessly, automatically, because you've got some inborn gift that nobody else has, then my dad is right. I'm no genius. But if genius is working with all of your heart on something that you love, that's endlessly fascinating to you, then I would say, Dad, you are a genius, and so am I, and so can everyone be if they choose to be. Thank you so much.